My name is Crystal Salinger, and I'm a docent at the Black Hawk Audio Museum. Today we're introducing the Isetta 300, 1960. The Isetta is an interesting little car. It was first built in 1953 by ISO in Italy. It was introduced in Turin, and it was based on two scooters and a refrigerator. In fact, the door handle was a refrigerator door handle. It was very popular when it was first introduced. But within a year, the novelty started wearing off a little bit. And ISO wanted to concentrate on their sports car. So they shopped around for licensing partners. And they found them all over the world. However, when they approached BMW in Germany, BMW said, oh, that's fine, but we keep the look, but we want to re-engineer. And so the very first thing they did, they pulled the motorcycle engine that was in there and put in a BMW motorcycle engine. It was bigger, it was stronger, it increased the top speed. It became very, very popular. It was the most popular single car produced in the world at the time. In 1958, they decided, okay, it is now time to start changing the outside a little bit. They removed the bubble windows, put in big sliding windows, and the car actually became pretty comfortable. Extremely spacious for its size, easy to get in and out of, and because of some of the engineering changes they made, didn't increase the horsepower, but it made it easier to go uphill. Unfortunately, by 1960, about the year that we have here on the floor, the car had reached about the price range of a Volkswagen Beetle. And people wanted a car that looked like a car. They no longer liked the little bubble. And the Isetta just no longer could compete with a Volkswagen Beetle. So in 2 years, the new model only sold 34,000 units. BMW stopped making Isettas totally by 1963. Because in 1961, they introduced the BMW 1500, and that swept the market. It raised BMW's income by 47%. And in 2 years, they sold almost 170,000 units compared to the 34,000 of the Isetta. I do remember the ads of about 1958, when they brought out the new version. Mom took the children to school, because it was very comfortable to take one child. Easy to get in, easy to get out. The steering wheel folded away with the door. However, Mom also went to the hardware store. She came out with big things. The guy said, where's your car? Well, right there, where I'm supposed to put it, easy. So she opened the sunroof and put everything in, because there was no trunk, obviously, but there was a back storage shelf. So that's where everything went, and no problem. Because of the narrow streets, and because of the lack of parking garages at the time, it became very popular for women just to ride around town. But like I said, by about 1960, it could not compete with a Volkswagen Beetle.